In this video, we are going to work with an Autodesk Inventor presentation file to create snapshot views. In addition to creating animated exploded assemblies, we can also take snapshot views of any given point in the exploded process. One of the reasons we might want to do this is to create drawing views and document the assembly. So here I have a presentation file that already has all of the tweaks added, and I'm at the beginning of the timeline here, and I want to create a snapshot view of the fully assembled view of this assembly. So I'll go ahead and come up top and select New Snapshot View. As you can see, a new snapshot was added over here on the right, and I can simply click on the name to rename it. I'll call this one Fully Assembled. Next, I can move to a point in the timeline and create another snapshot. So I'm going to move to about the 2.5 second mark here when the fasteners are pulled up, but they're not quite invisible yet. And I'll take another snapshot. So I'm going to document the steps of the exploded assembly. So I'll simply call this one step one. I'll move further into my assembly here to about the 6 second mark after this bracket has been pulled. And I'll take another snapshot. This time, of course, I'm going to call this one step two. If we take a look at the snapshots in the timeline, we'll see a couple of symbols. First of all, the arrow symbol here indicates that this is an associative view. If something changes in the presentation file, the snapshot will automatically update. The blue one just simply indicates that is the current one. That's where my timeline is right now. I can continue adding new snapshots at each step. In the interest of time, I'll go ahead and jump forward in the video. Now you can see I've added in several different snapshots for each step of the assembly. Next, we'll take a look at how we can modify these snapshot views. For example, in this last step, the bracket and the plate pull apart, and I would actually like just the bracket to move. I don't want the plate to move. So I'm going to right-click on my step 7 snapshot here and select Edit. This takes me into a new window, and I can make changes, and it's only going to be saved to this particular snapshot. So I can expand my scene, find my last tweak here where it tweaked the plate, and then I'll just right click and delete that. You can see that it's going to break a link to the timeline. So I'll go ahead and click Break Link, then I can click Finish Edit View. And you can see that my snapshot updated. You can also see the little arrow symbol is gone. It's no longer related to the timeline. It's an independent view. Next, we'll make a change that affects all of the dependent views. So in these steps here, the bolts pull out, but then they disappear, so they don't show up in any of the following steps. We are going to get rid of that particular step. So I'm going to expand one of the fasteners, right-click on the opacity here, and delete it. Then I'll go ahead and repeat the same thing with all four fasteners, so that way they stay visible the entire time. Now, after deleting those, if I take a look at my snapshot views, I can see a refresh button on most of these views. I can update the view to get the most recent version. Now you can see the fasteners show up in each one of these. The very last view, though, remember I modified that and broke the link. It is no longer a dependent view. I don't have the choice of being able to show the fasteners in this one. We can also adjust the camera view of any of these snapshots. I'm going to right-click on one of these steps here and edit it. And I'll just simply change my camera angle to an obviously different angle here. Then I will select Update Camera. Then finish edit view. So you'll notice that the snapshot updated. You'll also notice that it didn't ask me if I wanted to break the link. Changing the camera doesn't change the assembly itself, so therefore it does not break the link. We can use the snapshot tool to create exploded assemblies as well. I'm going to return to the beginning of my timeline, and I am going to make a new snapshot, and I'll just simply call it exploded view here. Then I can edit the snapshot. Then, just like I normally would, I would go ahead and add tweaks here. So I can tweak these components as I desire. So I'll just add a few in here a little bit differently than the first assembly. So notice the big difference here is I'm not really using a timeline anymore. I'm just simply pulling these parts apart and not really worrying about any sort of animation. I'll go ahead and tweak some additional components here. Again, trying to do it slightly different than the original. And I'll bring this wheel up instead. So once again, I'm really just focused on the view itself. I'm not worried about the timeline or any of the steps of the animation. Just looking for the exact exploded view that I want. I can go ahead and update my camera, finish my view, and I've got a new snapshot view here that I can use. I'll switch to a drawing sheet, and again, one of the big advantages of creating these snapshots is the ability to document our assembly. So as I create a view of an assembly, I can see that I have a drop down here where I can choose any snapshot throughout that process. So if I wanted to, I can create several views and show each step of the assembly process here on this sheet. That concludes this look at the creation of snapshot views in Autodesk Inventor presentation files.